Hi, this video continues a discussion about bags and the initial implementation using fixed capacity bags with a discussion about dynamic capacity bags. So a way in which the size of the capacity of the bag may change during the use of the bag. We start by creating a class for dynamic capacity bags and named we'll name it dynamic capacity bag, and we'll also generate, we'll add an interface that is implemented by this class, the bag interface, and we'll generate comments for this class. So once we do that, a template is created by Eclipse for us, and we'll add all the unimplemented methods. First, we'll need to specify that this class also uses generics, so it will be a dynamic capacity bag of an item, and we'll implement the bag of an item as well. So this class will implement a bag with a dynamic capacity that will increase as the number of elements will increase. The data structure is similar with a fixed capacity bag. We'll keep all the elements in the bag in an array of items, and also we keep the number of elements currently in the bag. Next, let's write the constructor, the dynamic capacity bag constructor, that will receive an initial capacity as a parameter. This parameter will reflect the size, the capacity of the array of elements when the bag is created. Now, also the bag will be empty, will have no elements, the number of elements will be zero, and the constructor is very similar with the fixed capacity. The implementation for is empty is just comparing the number of elements with zero, similar with the fixed capacity, and for the size we return the number of elements. To add a new item in the bag, we look if we are at the end of the bag, if the bag is full, and if it's full, we need to double the capacity. To double the capacity, we'll create a private method that will create a new array of items, and this array will have as size double the length of the original array, and we'll copy in this new array all the elements that were in the previous array. So we'll use a for with an index, going through all the elements in the original array and copying them element by element in the new array. Now, in the end, we update the field, elements field, to keep the new array that was created. Now that we know that we have enough space in our array to add the new item, because we doubled the capacity if it was full, we can add to the current elements a new item, and we'll also increment the number of elements. We also add a javadoc comment to our new method double capacity. We'll generate the iterator in the same way like in the fixed capacity bag. Same for the toString method that will have a similar implementation like for the fixed capacity bag. Now let us move in testbag file and create another method to test a dynamic capacity bag, in which we'll just modify how we construct the bag using the constructor for the dynamic capacity, and also we will be able now to add a six element in the bag. Let us call this new method in the main program and run the program, As you can see, we have the new bag created with the money item. However, we don't print the operation, so let's add the operation in our test method to specify that we add the sixth element, the sixth item money, and now the output looks good. Let's put a breakpoint in our test method and look at the internal representation for the bag. As you can see, we'll have the elements, the six elements at the beginning of the array, and the number of elements will be six. Now, that's where we stop the program. We can continue now to execute the entire program. As a programmer, I don't like to write the code twice, but as you can see, we have the same toString method in both fixed and dynamic capacity bags. So what if we'll create a method that is common? Now, the main problem is that toString, it's already in the API for both of them. So what we'll do, we'll create another method in which we'll specify how we want to display these bags. So we'll specify that the starting of the bag list, like the bracket that we use, the ending bracket or some other character that we'll use at the end, and the separator between the elements of the list, so which currently was space but can be any other separator. So implementing such a method will allow us to customize how we want to display the bag. This will specify the same signature for all the implementations, but we'll still need to implement it in all the both in the fixed and dynamic bag. However, we can create a default implementation here in the interface. We just put default B for the signature and we write the implementation. The implementation is similar. We start with a result as a starting string, that we add all the items to the starting string. Be careful, you need to use only methods that are visible in the interface. That's important. And we'll use an init separator now that is first false. And if it's if we need the separator, we'll add the separator to the result. If it doesn't need the separator, like in the first case, we just need to specify, okay, next time we'll need a separator. So the separator is the separator before the element. So that's the only difference. And at the end, we put the end string and return the result. Now we can rewrite our toString method to use this method defined in the interface with some predefined values. For instance, this is exactly the same definition like before, and we will put it both in the fixed capacity bag, but also we need to place it in the dynamic capacity bag. This new method is pretty powerful. Let's add a custom print for our bag. We'll start to print by writing bag, then we'll end with a dot, and we'll separate with comma space. Let's see how this runs. Now you can see that we have bag twice because we wrote it once bag as a string and then in the toString. So let's delete the string, keep it only the toString generation. In the end, we like to create a new constructor for our dynamic capacity bag that will have a default initial capacity. So we don't specify any initial capacity in the signature, but we'll call our constructor with an initial capacity, let's say, of 10. Now, in our test method, in testback class, we can use this new constructor to create the list.